the head of the Philippines' first sovereign wealth fund, finally named. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has tapped Rafael Consing Jr. as the president and chief executive of the Maharlika Investment Corporation. He is currently heading the office of the presidential advisor for investment and economic affairs. Consing also took on leadership roles in various financial institutions, including HSBC and Aboitiz Equity Ventures. This development comes days after Malacañang released the MIF's revised implementing rules and regulations, which drew flak from critics. But the Philippine Finance Department asserts changes in the fund's IRR are all within the bounds of the law. It also referred to the revisions as enhancements, which are intended to set up a strong corporate governance structure. Fitch Ratings affirms the Philippines' BBB investment grade rating while keeping its stable outlook on the country. It cited the economy's strong medium-term growth prospects. A BBB rating, which is a notch above the minimum investment grade, indicates that expectations of default risk are currently low. It also means that the country's current capacity for payment of financial commitments is considered adequate. Manila has maintained a BBB credit rating since December 2017. Fitch also expects Philippine inflation to slow down to 3.5% by year 2025. Philippine Central Bank Governor Eli Remolona welcomes the upbeat outlook, adding they will continue their data-dependent approach in managing inflation expectations. After two straight months of acceleration, inflation in the Philippines eased in October, coming in at 4.9%. Another big-time oil price rollback set this week. Diesel prices will be cheaper by 3 pesos per liter, while kerosene prices will see a 2 peso and 30 centavo drop. Gasoline prices also set to go down by 70 centavos per liter. Meanwhile, some transport groups welcome a possible jeepney fare rollback amid the decline of fuel prices, but they assert safeguards should be in place to ensure cheap prices of fuel in the long run.
Wala namang problema ba yun? Pero gaano ba ka-stabilize yung magiging presyo na yan? Kung yung ba talagang tatagal na sa presyo na yan, kailangan natin yung assurance na hindi natataas doon sa mahabang panahon. Napakahirap po kasi ng aming katatayuan. Kung amin naman babawin kagad, pagtaos bigla naman tataas, eh napakabigat para sa amin yan. Mga dalawang bagsak pang ganyan kasakay, okay na kami dyan.
Motorists illegally using the EDSA bus carousel lane will face stiffer penalties beginning today, November 13th. Let's get an update from our correspondent, Jackie Manaba. Jackie, over to you.
Hermina, the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority, or MMDA, flagged down 333 vehicles in the first 3 hours of implementing higher fines for those using the EDSA busway illegally. The vehicles that the enforcers flagged down this morning were a mix of private vehicles, unmarked government vehicles, and motorcycles. Under the MMDA regulation approved by the Metro Manila Council, the increased fines for the violation of exclusive city bus lane for public and private vehicles are 5,000 pesos for the first offense, 10,000 pesos plus 1 month suspension of driver's license for the second offense, 20,000 pesos plus 1 year suspension of driver's license for a third offense, and finally for the fourth offense, 30,000 pesos plus recommendation to LTO for the revocation of the driver's license. This means that for the first 3 hours this morning, MMDA will be able to collect 1.67 million pesos in fines unless the driver or drivers can successfully contest the issued ticket. Only the EDSA bus carousel unit, emergency vehicles, and government vehicles are allowed to fly the road, the EDSA bus carousel. MMDA was quick to clarify that the higher fines are a way to deter violators rather than a money-making scheme. One of the vehicles flagged down was a government vehicle with incomplete vehicle markings. MMDA, however, was strict with the rules and issued a ticket. MMDA, however, admitted that the rules for government vehicles need clarification, as some would have pending vehicle registrations or logos printed on paper. MMDA Chairman Don Artes said he has recommended to the Department of Transportation to limit the allowed government vehicles that will fly the EDSA busway to the top 5 government officials: the President, the Vice President, Chief Justice, Speaker of the House, and Senate President. And more than half of those flagged down Monday morning are motorcycle riders. Most said they momentarily passed their bus lane to beat the EDSA traffic. Some police officers, delivery riders, and motorcycle taxis, and even MMDA personnel. MMDA Chairman Artes said they will not tolerate violators, especially those under their agency. From January until this morning, MMDA flagged down around 12,000 vehicles. The agency hopes that these higher fines, starting today, will discourage motorists from flying the exclusive EDSA bus lane.
China continues to hide in its gray operations to mask its aggressive maritime behavior. That's according to the Philippine Coast Guard following the latest encounter between Manila and Beijing off the West Philippine Sea. Commodore Jay Tariela says at this point, there should be no competition in terms of narrative, adding the public should not fall for China's misinformation campaign.
One of the main reasons why we are embedding journalists and our media friends is for them to tell the right story, the accurate. On the part of the Chinese, I don't want to glorify their own version of a video clip because I know for a fact what really happened. We have more factual narrative and it's supported by those media who boarded our Philippine Coast Guard vessels.
Commodore Tariela also vows the Philippines will never militarize maritime disputes.
It's better that we use the supply boats, not the Navy vessels, because we don't want to escalate the tension. We don't want to provoke anybody, whether it's China or any other claimant states. We want to show the world that we are in alignment with the regional norm of not militarizing the dispute.
A maritime security analyst warning the Philippines is in for a long and hard contest with China over disputed waters. Ray Powell believes it will take some time for China to change its aggressive behavior in the South China Sea.
I think that it will take a little while for China to decide how it wants to modify its behavior. So far, I think China believes that it can outlast the Philippines here, that if they simply hold the line, that eventually what will happen is either the Philippines will just give up on this, or the Sierra Madre will break up and slide off the shoal. So I think that that's China's calculation right now. However, this is not going away anytime soon unless one of those two things happen. And so I think both the Philippines and China are probably potentially looking into, you know, a potentially long-term situation where every resupply mission is going to look like this until somebody decides to change course. So to some degree, it's a test of nerve. The Philippines has engaged the weapons that it has to hand, and the best weapon is this transparency campaign, because the Philippines is so clearly in the right, and all it has to do is show the world.
On the line, RJ Cruz now for more on the House Speaker's reaction to the Vice President's decision to drop her bid for confidential funds. RJ, go ahead.
Yes, House Speaker Martin Romualdez hailed the decision of Vice President Sara Duterte not to pursue her confidential funds anymore, while standing by the administration's unity team of the Vice President and President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., despite differences. Romualdez said he is hopeful the relations with the Dutertes will improve. This after the House recently passed the resolution upholding the integrity and dignity of the House in defense of the attacks of former President Rodrigo Duterte after the House took away the Vice President's 2024 confidential fund. The former President's eldest son, of course, Pulong, is the Davao City First District Representative. Romualdez also maintained that the Dutertes can still be trusted when he was asked by the media. The House chief admits that at the same time downplays a rift in the unity, maintaining that the team is still together. He said that, and I quote, as they always say, there will always be differences, but we will always work towards resolving those differences for the service of the Filipino people, and that is our primordial concern, that we will band together and unite as one for the service of the Philippines.